Looking at San Angelo State Park, the sprawling natural beauty can seem to be in perfect balance, but it is actually through the diligent work of park and city staff the land remains viable for the animals and visitors' activities.
It's with some of those trails, one of them is 9 miles one way, and if you want to do round trip, it's 18, 20 miles. There's a few water fountains spread out along the way, along with horse troughs. Some of the people bring their, what do they call them, life straws, stuff like that to filter water and drink. Otherwise, they got to pack it in.
Those fountains, as well as the drinking troughs for horses, are fed by city water. The Concho River flows too irregularly to sustain the needs of the park, and O.C. Fisher Reservoir was not built with those needs in mind either.
The biggest thing that we do have is Lake O.C. Fisher out there. The North Concho River feeds it, and of course it doesn't have much of a watershed. The watershed runs from Big Spring down through Sterling City, and it's not much. And the lake was never really designed to hold water. It was more designed to prevent flooding for San Angelo coming in the North Concho River.
Without the city water, both the animals and natural wildlife would not be able to inhabit the park in current numbers.
We couldn't sustain the amount of longhorn that we have right now with just the city water troughs without putting in more troughs. The bison are the same. They live off of the city water as well in the troughs because there's no man-made ponds or any kind of water up there. They're not on the lake. They're in a separate pasture. The deer, they thrive on the river up in areas 6 and 7 of the state park, and then the water troughs that we have out there for the cattle, they live around them.
For Our Water, I'm Victor Glenn.
For more Our Water stories, visit ConchoValleyHomepage.com/water.